What are the most important conferences we're going to have in social housing this year? And let's hope other regions across the country do the same as we're having today, which is have a conversation about racing housing.
I was told then that the reason there aren't any black people in leadership was there weren't enough of us, we weren't qualified. Why, in 2023, do the majority of our boardrooms not represent the demographics of our tenants? Why is the leadership not representative of the people that we are serving?
What happens at Grenfell doesn't just sit in social housing. We've moved from a welfare state to a care state. And more we put our public services into private hands where money is the ultimate object, we suffer disproportionately. And in Grenfell, people pay the ultimate price with their lives.
What we've worked with providers, some of those workshops with our colleagues to say, actually, if you want to be open and we want to be an open environment for people to work in, we've got to change. It's not just, we can't just carry on doing the same way. We can't expect people to suddenly go into a situation that is completely alien to them.
If you haven't read Kamal Ahmed Ali's professionals briefing, you should read it. These are nationally relevant reports. Both men died, at least partly because of failures in housing.
You know, why can't they have the same rights like us? Starting from housing, but not only housing, but also with the skills and the right investment, you know, to help them gain into employment, to move them away from social housing, to move them away from poverty.
We worked with Ukraine most recently. Those people are coming in from horrific social situations. The issue is constantly, though, is making sure that we find realistic, relatable, credible mentors who can work with these people to be able to help them.
Our team resettles refugees who've been brought here by the Home Office. 700 people from Ukraine who've come to Bristol, 350 households, and they all arrived on a 3-year visa following the war. So those families moved in with settled UK families.
The immigration is bad for the United Kingdom. Multiculturalism and diversity is not a settled issue in their minds. And all of that has fed that space that became the Windrush scandal at the highest levels of government and the institutions.
We often have families that are originally housed in accommodation in high-rise blocks. They become incredibly overcrowded as your family grows. They may be a 5 or 6 bedroom need and they won't give it to them because the minute they do, they'll be overcrowded anyway and then the local authority could serve notice on them, which happens. So that individual's then trapped in a house that really isn't fit for them.
We discovered that one of our buildings had a fire safety issue, so we talked to all of the residents in that building about what we were going to do to make that property safe. And one of the residents said to us, we've been living in an unsafe building for 10 years. Is it because we're black? It's really important that we make sure that those voices are listened to and encouraged.
We had a failing system. The 80s were very difficult. All of those, with the housing issues, but also through unemployment, also through policing. And it was about the not just the fabric of the people, of the buildings, but also the people that was in it. And that was in terms of rent. So that was a clear policy. And not only through positive action, you had local people that were employed in housing offices, employed in housing associations. So that localism was the key.
I remember starting off a meeting called Inclusive, Not Exclusive. We also had staff in the room who had for many years gone on every single leadership course you could think about, and somehow the organisations were still failing to elevate them. And we have put 620 people through the Stepping Up programme over the last 5 years.
If you think about the social housing sector claiming or positioning themselves as change makers, receiving public investment, there's an obligation to ensure that all of their tenants, all of their stakeholders are treated fairly.
If we can hold ourselves to account for those commitments we're making today, I think we will be a better sub-region as a result and a better sector.
But sometimes what we do is we nudge the compass just 1 degree, and at the time you don't notice, right? It's very subtle. But in 10, 15 years, you're in a totally different place than the one you would have been. Your legacy will live on in those lives and all that we go on to achieve. So thank you.